Hi there guys, welcome to my lightly tutorial. In this tutorial I will be showing you how I create my light leaks for that sort of vintage sort of look. Yeah, so first of all what I'll do is I'll just show you an example of a light leak, a real light leak. As you can see, it starts off with like a sort of white and then it sort of fades into yellow and it blends into a red. There are other sort of light leaks, but for this tutorial I'll focus on this white to red. The first method is just to manually paint in the light leaks. I use this sometimes for control, because I like to have control over my image. What I do is I select a red and a yellow. You may start off in white, but because I have white already in the image, I don't need the white. Try not to set the yellow, like the one which is the uppermost corner. Just an off yellow would be better. So I select the brush tool, soft. Make sure it's on 100%, and then just paint in on a new layer where you want the yellows to be. Now yellow starts off after white, so I'm just going to do it on the top right corner and the bottom areas. And when I'm happy with the light, what I see with the yellows, I'll change to red. I'll just start painting in the red. With a soft brush, what will happen is it would create a sort of a little bit of yellow in between, orange in between the red and the yellow. So once I'm happy with what I see, I'll change the blend mode to that layer to screen mode. Now what I'll do now is I grab the move tool, or the free transform tool. I'll just move it around and adjust it to the way I like. So I'm just stretching the image out. I think that's quite nice. Just gonna do this. I think I might rotate it a little bit as well. Now bear in mind, you could adjust this to the way you want to adjust it. For the sake of this tutorial, I'm just going to show you quickly how to achieve a quick effect for light leaks. You could go in further and just make more oranges in there or blend it better, but yeah. So I'm just going to name that number one, as that's the first one I'm going to show you. Just going to create a couple more layers. Let's call this number two. Duplicate it. So the second method involves using curves. With this one, you do have a lot more control with it, and but it's very sensitive, so you have to use a low opacity brush for this one. I'll show you what I do now. So you go in curves, you go in RGB, and you turn it up, just like I'm doing on the right hand side with the red as well, exactly the same place. Now with green, you go in the opposite direction and you bring it down to about there. Same with the blue. So it creates a sort of burnt out sort of red. Now what I do is I'll set the paint bucket and paint that layer with black, so it hides that layer. Now what I do is I get the brush tool, select white, and press and choose an opacity of about 20%. Now what you do is you just start painting in where you want the light leaks. Now, the more you paint over a certain area, the more stronger the red gets. So you could sort of just fake the strength of the light leak, if you want to call it like that. I really like this method because it can be very, very accurate. But as I said, it can be very fiddly at the same time. So you have to know what you're doing and to make it look sort of realistic. So let's take a look. So I'm just turning the opacity down just slightly on this one. So I'm hiding now. I'm making another adjustment layer for the yellows. So I'm gonna select blue this time, the blue channel, and I'm just gonna bring it down. Oops, sorry. Let me just move that layer. There you go. So just move the point which you made until you find a nice yellow. It's up to you which yellow you want, but it's best off if you sort of just experiment yourself, to be honest. So once you've found something which you like, I think I'm just gonna go with a strong yellow for this one, just to show you what it's gonna be like. Again, I'm just gonna paint that layer with black, and then I'm gonna paint back in with a white brush. I turn the red layer back on, and then I'm just gonna start painting in. So yeah, once you go over the some of the red parts, it will naturally just blend in together. This is a really nice way. To be honest, if I took a little bit, if I was doing this properly, I would take more time and get the colors better and stuff. But for this tutorial, I'm just going to show you a quick way how to do it. So once you're happy, I'm just gonna merge the layers. Hide that. Okay, let's start number three. The third technique is a very, very simple technique. You literally just get a stock image of a light leak, copy and paste it in, and then select the screen, change the blend mode to screen mode. And you just have an instant light leak. Grab the move tool or the free transform tool and just move it about. Find somewhere where you like. This technique is really good if you're lazy. I use this technique a lot sometimes. But if I wanted more control, I would use the other two techniques. So I'm just gonna move this about. Yeah, I think that looks about right. I'm just gonna merge these together. Now, what you could do now is create a new layer, fill this with 50% gray, and create like a sort of grain layer for that film effect. So 50% gray, okay, hit okay. Go and filter, add noise. Make sure monochromatic is checked. Change the blending mode to soft light. It's a bit too grainy for my liking, so I'll just turn it down to about around there. Looks good to me. So I'm liking that now. So I'm just going to show you one more time. First technique, sec. Yep. First technique, second technique, and the third technique. If you like my video, guys, please subscribe and like my Facebook page. Yeah, just experiment with different sort of colors as well, because it can work with cool blue as well. Blue and purple works really cool.